In this video, you're going to discover exactly how I made over $100,000 on Upwork.com by building my own SEO link building agency. So maybe you want to make that sweet moolah, you want to start your own business, maybe travel the world and stop being an office drone, then keep watching this video because it will teach you exactly how to do this with Upwork.com and it doesn't cost you a single penny. Plus, I'll reveal some exclusive tips for making money on Upwork that I've never revealed before. So keep watching if you want to learn more. So how did this all happen? Well, essentially a few years ago, I started living the Upwork dream when I quit my office job, left England, left all my friends and family, as you do, and then moved over to Chiang Mai, Thailand. And that's when I started working online with Upwork. Now, the thing is, when I first started working with Upwork, I was really cheap and very bad at monetizing myself. In fact, I was so cheap, the Indians used to outsource to me, okay? So I was that cheap, and along the way, I started learning different things about how to use the platform, how to make money, how to start scaling up a business. And that's when I discovered that actually Upwork can be incredibly profitable. Now, this isn't my main source of income, to be honest. I have loads of different sources of income, and it's just something I've built up over the years. But Upwork is extremely profitable if you know the secrets to using it. And that's exactly what I'm going to show you in this video. So we're going to split it into three sections, right? First of all, picking a niche, then marketing yourself, and finally, how to sell. And then also after that, I'm going to show you loads of bonus tips on how to use Upwork and how to make lots of money off it. So let's just jump straight in and I'll show you how. So if you don't know what Upwork is, this is basically a platform for freelancers to find jobs and for clients to find freelancers. It's kind of like eBay for jobs, right? And basically all you need to do is sign up to Upwork. It takes about 2 minutes. Even your grandma could do it. It's that easy. And then after that, you need to pick a niche. And this is really important. It can make or break your business. And if you don't spend time picking the niche, you're wasting your time and you might as well not do it, okay? So what you need to do is pick a really solid foundation for your Upwork business. So for me, for example, I picked link building, and that's because it's very scalable, it's high ticket. You know, I only work with clients who are ready to spend at least $1,000 or more per month. Something with high retention rates, so our clients are gonna hire you every single month. And also something that you're confident of doing a good job. If you can't do a good job, you're wasting your time and you're wasting your clients' money as well. So you've really gotta focus on something that you can sell for a lot of money, but also ethically, you can perform a very good job that's gonna make your client lots of money in the long run too. So that's something to think about. Now, a lot of people when it comes to Upwork are worried about competition. And that's true, there's tons of freelancers on there. Everyone's scrambling for money on there. Everyone's scrambling for jobs. But the truth is that if you market yourself properly and you truly understand the value of your business, then you don't need to worry about competition. Competition is irrelevant because most of the people you're competing against are really low value freelancers who have no idea what they're doing. And without being disrespectful, usually they're not gonna do a very good job. So if you can offer a great service that your clients love, then you're gonna win every time and your client's gonna win every time too. So that's why I don't worry about competition on Upwork. In fact, if you look, there's probably hundreds, if not thousands, of link builders on Upwork, but I don't worry about any of them, okay? They don't have the same system as me, they don't have the same amount of reviews, same amount of case studies, you can't deliver as good a service as me, and therefore, they're just not gonna win when we're head on against a client. But to be honest, they're probably a bit more humble than me, but you know, you go big or you go home, right? So anyway, next up, you've gotta start marketing your profile and selling who you are as a person, because when there's thousands of freelancers competing against you, you wanna be the one that stands up, right? You wanna be like the cream of the crop, and then you have all these other freelancers below you that can't match your personality, your marketing, and everything else that's on your profile, right? So for me, when you look at my profile, you know, it's got a very direct headline, it's got a sales page that shows a lot of personality and draws the customer in, but then also explains the benefits and the reasons why they should pick me as a freelancer compared to every single other person on Upwork, right? And then next up, there's a clear call to action. So when customers read through the page, they can see at the end that there's a clear call to action on what they need to do next if they want to work to me. Now, the other thing I'd say also is I have included a couple of qualification answers in my Upwork profile. Personally, I don't want to work with broke clients who don't have a lot of money and can't afford me and make loads of excuses about why they don't pay me in the end. So I have to be very careful about who they work with, and I'm very selective about that, and I clearly show that in my Upwork profile. Now, this is really powerful because it demonstrates your value as an agency or as a freelancer, because it shows, you know, you've got options. And it's kind of like when you're on holiday, you're starving, you're looking for a restaurant, you walk down the street and you see two different options, okay? One restaurant has tons of customers, has a really good energy about it. You can see they're busy, but they're also enjoying the job. And then you see this other old dusty restaurant, the lights are kind of dim, the staff are looking really bored and there's nothing going on, and you think, right, okay, I'm always gonna go for the busier restaurant, just like you're always gonna go for the busier freelancer, simply because if they're busy, they must be good, they're in demand, right? And it's the same with Upwork. So you can use this on your profile to optimize it and land more customers. And the final and most important thing about making money on Upwork is to sell, 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 okay? So I hear some people say on Upwork, right, I've sent 10 proposals today and I've got nothing back. That doesn't matter. For me, I'll send 100 proposals if it takes one sale. It doesn't matter. The way I think about it is like you're a dinosaur, you're going out there to hunt, and if you don't eat, you're gonna die, right? And it's the same with sales. If you don't sell and you're on Upwork and you're trying to make money online, then you need to sell as much as possible. And sales is so important. It's something you have to learn to love to do. At first, I was very shy when I did it. In fact, the first time I got onto a client call, I was actually like shaking a little bit, like, hello? But you know, eventually you get very good at sales, you enjoy it, you love the process, and it becomes extremely rewarding. The other thing is as well, that if you can learn to sell, you're gonna make money not just on Upwork, but pretty much everywhere. Every single business requires some sales. Even if you wanna work for someone else, they need salesmen, and sales is one of the most important and powerful skills that you can ever learn to grow a business. So that's something I recommend, is spending, you know, 90% of your time when you go on Upwork, spending your time on sales. You know, every single day, first thing in the morning, I send 10 proposals. I look at every single link building job that I possibly can, find the ones that are right for me, and then reply to them. And this is so important, because with sales, it's just kind of a numbers game, right? You just have to get your name out there, and if you're in front of enough clients, you will land a sale. So this is why it's so important for your business. Next up, you gotta price yourself properly, okay? So you gotta know your own worth when it comes to Upwork, because otherwise you will get screwed, and you have to be very careful about negotiating rates with clients on Upwork, because at the end of the day, they just wanna save as much money as possible and you wanna provide the best service you possibly can. And you can't do that if you're not getting paid enough. So the biggest mistake I ever made was being so cheap that I thought everyone would want to buy from me. But at the same time, if you're extremely cheap, it doesn't represent your value and it makes you look like a very low value freelancer. So that's why I recommend pricing yourself properly, making sure your worth is there in the pricing and that you price yourself in a way that makes you stand out from your competition. This is so damn important. And the other thing is as well, if you want a scalable business, then you have to price yourself at a high price point. The only thing I will say is that you have to make sure you can deliver an amazing service that comes along with the price tag. You know, don't just price yourself at $1,000 and then deliver something that's absolutely terrible, because that's only gonna frustrate your clients and it's gonna look terrible on you and it's gonna hurt your reputation in the long run. So that's why I recommend pricing yourself, but also delivering an amazing service along the way. Now, another thing that I'd recommend is using proposal templates, okay? So on Upwork, you're gonna be sending hundreds of proposals if you're applying for jobs. So you might as well make this as quick as possible, and that's why I recommend using proposal templates. You can quickly copy, paste, and personalize them to the job that you're applying for, and it will save you hours and hours of time, because instead of rewriting a whole new proposal from scratch, you can quickly copy and paste it into Upwork. It will save you time and it will make the whole process a lot more efficient. Now, something to keep rolled up your sleeve is case studies, because case studies are like social proof to show that your service actually gets results, because there's no point trying to make money on Upwork if your service doesn't benefit anyone. And for me, yes, I'm focused on money, but also I'm focused on delivering an amazing service for the clients I work with, okay? So for example, for me, with link building in my agency, I've got loads of case studies where I can show I've got proven results of how my link building benefits my clients. I've also got loads of example websites that I've created myself and I can show my clients, and you know, they personally benefit me, but they also show the client that, hey, the link building, he doesn't just do it for clients, he does it for himself too, and therefore it must be an extremely valuable service. The other thing that I use is YouTube videos, okay? So I create loads of case studies on YouTube with results of how my link building can grow a website, you know, how I've 10x traffic overnight, and how I've used my own link building strategies to benefit my websites and other websites too. So, you know, the thing is, if you're going to be selling a lot on Upwork, you really need something that can make you stand out. And case studies are so powerful for that, because they act like social proof. You know, they do most of the selling for you. And if you can prove that your service benefits people in a tangible way, then you're going to stand out as a freelancer on Upwork. And most freelancers on Upwork, they can't prove that they've got the results. You know, they don't have very good case studies or portfolios. So if you can create an amazing one, then you're gonna stand out by a mile and it's gonna separate you from 99% of freelancers on Upwork.com. Now, something that's extremely important to clients and something that I recommend you do is making sure that you're available for calls with potential clients that wanna sign up with you, okay? Because most of the time, they're not gonna grill you on some crazy topic about the service that you deliver, but they do wanna know that there's someone genuine and authentic at the end of the line. So that's why I recommend being able to jump on calls with clients when you're on Upwork. And this will separate you from freelancers as well, because most freelancers, they're either scared of jumping on the call, they don't want to waste their time, maybe they don't know what to say on a sales call. And therefore, if you jump on a call with a client, it's going to separate you from most of the freelancers on the platform. Plus, it's a great way to sell your services too. If you're on the phone to someone, you can easily explain the benefits of what you do, some case studies, and there are all these different ways of selling on the phone that will make you stand out and help you land more sales and make more money with Upwork. And like I say, the first time I jumped on a sales call, it was actually really difficult. I was quite shy, you know, I was worried about what the client was going to say. I thought that, you know, it was just going to be an extremely hard sales call, but at the end of the day, it was easy and all they wanted was a conversation. And nowadays I love jumping on calls with clients, you know, because it's a great way to understand their problems, speak to them and understand their situation so that I can deliver a better service. So this is something I recommend if you're freelancing on Upwork or if you run an agency too. So thanks for watching this video on how I made over $100,000 on Upwork.com. I really hope these tips helped you. And if you have any questions about setting up your Upwork profile or SEO in general, please let me know in the comment section below and I'll be really happy to help. And we've got 51 subscribers now. So if you're watching this and you haven't liked the video already, please do. I know you want to keep the information to yourself, but it makes a huge difference to me and to YouTube's algorithm if you smash a like on the video so that I can help more people with my videos. Thanks for watching.